Okay, so we're going to be making these cool little envelope journals, and I'm going to show you a couple that I've made, and we'll get started with them. So this is my favorite one so far. I've painted the background, and then I've done some stamping and stenciling. So here's one pocket, because that's the envelope. I've got these great big square envelopes. And then some stencils and stamps, and then another pocket here, and then the third pocket's up here. And then when it closes, you have this flap. I mean, if you didn't want that, you could just keep it back here, but it's sort of a cool way to finish it off. So this, the backgrounds of this one, all that is transparent red iron oxide and transparent yellow iron oxide put on with a sponge. That's all I used. And then this one is a little different. Let's see, I think I don't have it the right way here. So this one I made with something called Color Burst watercolor powders. And it's just got this cool effect. I've put links to some of these materials in the chat because you may want to try some of these at some point. You sprinkle the powder on and then you get a spray bottle and you spray it as much as you want or as little, because it looks like confetti when you don't spread it out too much. And then again, stencils and stamps. I haven't done the back. And so this is what we're going to be making today. And I want to show you something else that can be done. I'm going to be, hopefully I'm going to be going on this French Riviera walking art trip in next September, a year from September. And we're going to be making pocket journals. And so I made a prototype. And these, again, these are these big envelopes. And I figured as we do our walks every day, we can collect ephemera and then, you know, journal on this page, but we could spend time in the studio first, you know, preparing the pages. So this one has, I think, 6 or 7 envelopes. And then I glued the front and the back. Oops. I glued them down to a file folder. I just love this pattern file folder. And then you can just see from the top. So, you know, if you like working with these envelopes, the sky's the limit with what you can do with them. The other thing you can do is almost create signatures, like glue a few together and then glue a few more together and keep adding them to make it bigger. So before I get started, this is what the watercolor powder looks like. It's called Ken Oliver Color Burst. And again, it's in the chat. And they just, I'll show you when I get ready to work on my next one. And then the other thing I've used for backgrounds is walnut ink sprays. And they're very subtle. They're weird colors. They're sort of pink, green, purple, and blue, but they don't really look like that once they dry. But they make, again, they make for a nice sort of easy background. And then the last thing I've put in the chat is this set of stencils, they're little stencils. They were specifically made for doing dot mandalas on rocks, which is really funny to me. These have created these wonderful designs. Here's one, and these are some. You know, I think they're just gorgeous for little stencils. So it's a big set, and it's like $10. So I learned this from Katherine Anderson, of course. She knows where to get all the good supplies. And then I just put it on a binder ring because they just came kind of loose. Okay, so for today, I'm going to first show you how to assemble your little journal. So this is the part where you probably want to follow along step by step. It took me a while, and I have to thank Diane for sending me a YouTube video of this woman who did this sort of journal first, because I've seen the bigger ones. I've never seen one with three. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to get your three envelopes and just have them just regular the right way up. Just if you have a long flap on top, whatever shape, it doesn't matter, but have them, you know, sort of piled up together so that you have the three all facing the same way. And then we're going to take the first one and we're going to open it up and have the flap on our right. I think that would be the easiest way to do it. Let me back away a little bit. No, that's too far. Okay, anyway, flap on the right. And then take the second envelope. And you're going to, so here they are the same. And you're going to turn the second envelope over so that the gummed side is on the other side. And you're going to slide it in. Just slide the flap into here. Now we're not gonna, this is just the practice run, because when you do it for real, we're gonna put glue on it so that it stays like that. So now you have the front cover, the first page, the second page, and then this is where it's a little different, where you're gonna take that third envelope, having it facing the same direction as the rest, but you're gonna just glue it on, you're gonna glue it onto that last flap, leaving a little bit of room so that it can fold closed, and then that becomes your cover. Okay? Anybody need me to run through that again? I'm happy to do it again if you need me to. Just
Yes, please do.
Yes, okay, sure. Okay, so have your three envelopes. Maybe this time it's easier if you have them with the flap on the right. And so you're going to open the first one out. And then open the second one out. And you're going to tuck this part of the second envelope into the pocket on this envelope. But right now you can see they both have the gummed side facing the same way. So you need to turn this one over so that the gummed side is underneath. Now they're still facing the same way. You're going to turn this one 180. So this one's facing to the right and this one's facing to the left. Okay. And then you're going to slide that flap into this pocket. And it can be a little fiddly. Sometimes it's easier if you sort of bend it a little so that it's sort of bent a little bit. It makes it a little easier to put inside. Okay, so that's the first connection. And then you turn this page over. So you want to make sure that you get that right the way down so that when it folds flat. And then your third envelope, same direction, same gummed flap as the first envelope. But with this one, we're going to just put glue on the flap of envelope number two, or is it one? Anyway, that flap, we're going to put glue on it and we're just going to lay this down. So this one doesn't get tucked in anywhere. We're going to lay it down and we're going to leave a little gap. So we could put it together like this so that they're touching. But what we're going to do is when we glue it, we're going to leave this tiny space. Okay, so that then this is going to become the cover and then this will close over it. So this is the back. This will get glued down too. But I'll take you through it step by step when we're ready to glue. Because I found it's a lot easier to work on these pages when they're all together. I did this one once I made up the journal, and I did this one all separate pages, and I had to dry them all separately. I mean, either way works, but I personally prefer putting it all together and then painting it and stuff. So here's the first envelope. The flap is underneath here somewhere. The second envelope has been glued in. The pointy part is in there. And then the third envelope is glued. There's a little gap here so that when you close it up, it lays flat. Does that make sense? Any questions?
Nope, that was good.
Okay, good. So now you want to get out your glue stick, because that's really all you're going to need. And we're going to start from the beginning again with our three envelopes. Okay. And glue stick and glue pad. So I can just put it down here. Need that right now. Okay. So I'm going to open up this first one. And I'm going to open up the second one. And I'm going to turn the second one over. And then I'm going to do a 180. So that one flap, the gummed side up facing the right, and one flap, the gummed side down facing the left. And then I'm going to bend it a little bit. You see how it's sort of bent? And I'm going to take this flap and open it so that this can go in much more easily if they're both kind of rounded. Let's see if I can show you better. So this one's a little rounded and this one's open and a little, well, it's just open. So we're going to put glue on the underside of this flap. You're going to put glue on the side that has that gummed area. So let's do that. And if you don't want to use glue, you can use medium, you can use any kind of adhesive, double-sided tape, whatever you want to. So I'm just going to glue this whole area. Lots and lots of glue because it's really dry in Prescott. We don't have our monsoon rains like we're supposed to. Okay, so now this has glue on it. I'm going to turn it over. I'm going to bend it up.
Okay.
I'm going to open up the envelope and I'm going to slide it in. And now that it's got sticky on it, you have to kind of force it a little bit. Now it's already sticking.
Yeah. They went faster than they thought.
What did?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm talking to somebody else.
Oh. Okay, let's see. So that's a mistake. So let's try and get it out before it sticks. It happens to the best of us. Okay. So you really want it to not stick until it gets all the way in. So let me put a little more glue. And this is the trickiest one. Okay, turn it over, open up the flap, slide it all the way in, there it goes. And then you want the lines to line up so that when you fold this over, it's all even. And then, so now you can just rub that glued area. You can turn it over if you want, okay? So that's step number one, is gluing in that first page to the second page. Does everyone understand how that one's done? Okay. And then you turn over that second page and you have the flap to the right. And again, you're going to glue the flap with the gummy side up. Lots of glue. You're going to take that third envelope and just disregard the flap. You're just going to glue it down onto that flap and leaving a little gap along that middle part. Get them lined up. And so then that one closes and that becomes your cover flap. Okay. So you should have something that looks like that. You know, it's a little hard to see, but you've got three pages. First page has a pocket, second page has a pocket, and then third page has a pocket. And when you close it up, you have a flap.
All right. A quick question, Kat.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to keep going, would you just repeat that pattern, tuck for the first, you know, for the first one and then the next one, glue it to the flap?
Yeah, so if you wanted to keep going, you wouldn't put the third envelope here. You would keep tucking in, tucking in, tucking in.
Oh, every single time, the tucking. Oh yeah, okay.
You know, actually this is done this way. So this envelope is tucked in here and glued. This envelope is tucked in here and glued. So you never do that last step. They all just tuck into each other.
So the last one that you do, would that be the one that got glued to the flap, or you never glue it to the flap?
No, never.
Never, okay.
No, you never glue it to the flap.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. Okay, so then it comes to how you want to decorate. And I'm going to show you how to paint, and I also have my jelly plate. So I'm going to use that to cover large spaces of it. If you prefer to, you know, to have each page look a little different, by all means, go right ahead and do that. It's just as much fun. But I'm going to, because I think, you know, if I opened it out and I could, you know, I could jelly print a lot of that and that. Got glue somewhere here. Alrighty, so I am going to do a similar color scheme to this one, which is the red, transparent red and yellow iron oxide, and I've just got brand new big bottles of it. Mm. Oh, they're just so yummy when they're new. And then I have another green gold, which is also nice. I may add a little bit of that in. And I think that's going to be it for colors. So let's get started. I'm just going to put some yellow. Move it over a little bit. Red. I like to mix them. They just blend really nicely, I think. Let's see how this goes. Yeah. So for the first layer, I'm just going to press it down. So I'm going to start like this. So I get like a pattern. I'm just going to keep going. And then for the second layer, I'll do a little more deliberate stuff. Just random to start with. Put more on and do it again. The other thing I love about the fluid acrylic paints is that it makes it almost feels like leather when the page is dry. there's just something kind of magical about it all. So that's as much as I want to do from the plate. Now I can roll it off with my roller for some of it. And I can also use a sponge, which is usually my first choice of things to use. So I'm just going to put a little more of these paints on here. And then it's just a makeup sponge. You just blob them together like that. And then you can just sort of rub it to fill in where it didn't take. And if you want it to be a little darker in places, then maybe don't blend them together and just like use one or the other. I'll just use the red for a minute. Dab it on like that, or you can rub it in. So you just get a nice effect, which you can then paint over or stencil or stamp over. But you do have to let it dry. So those of you who don't live in a hot climate that's dry right now, you might want to get your hair dryer and speed that up. This one's almost dry already. That's how we roll in Arizona. Okay, and then I just throw this in some water. This thing's lasted me a couple of years now. Crazy. So once that's dry, then you just open it up and do the same or do something different. I think for this one, since this is the covers on the inside, I'm going to try something a little different. So yeah, that's dry. Alrighty. So on the inside, let's see, I have green gold high flow and green gold just regular. Let's try some of these. Put that with the yellow. I love that color green. That's cool. The paint doesn't take real well on the gummed part, but if you dab it on a couple times, it will take. Or you can just glue a piece of paper over that or put some washi tape or something, and then it'll stick to that. Do that again. Let's try the high flow, if there's any way of opening it. There. I don't know if there's anything in here. We'll find out. Oh!
Hello.
Hello. I guess there's something there. Okay, where can I put all this? Here. A big experiment. Okay. Well, let's see. You can always leave the sponge pattern on. Remember when we all used to sponge paint our walls?
Yeah.
So, you know, on a journal, it'll look nice. On the walls, in this day and age, not so much. Unless you're really, really clever about it. So that on one side, and this on this side, and then I have these two, but I do need to let these dry. This one's much wetter because I put so much on there. So I think it might be time for a baby wipe. And I'm going to pause the recording. Okay. I think this might be dry by now. Oops, not really. However, I think I'm going to just put it down on my mat and then try something different for these pages. Okay, I also have a gold somewhere. I love doing the iridescent. Yeah, do an iridescent gold. And maybe, maybe a hot pink. Let's try that. Oh, that's fun. That one again. Got some bubble wrap here. I'm going to use it like a stamp, I think. Actually, I should probably do it on a different page. Let's see. Very subtle. Yeah, it's kind of pretty. But now, the real magic. My handy dandy sponge again. All right. I'll let that dry. And stop the recording again. So I think now my pages are all dry. And so I think it's time to start thinking about stencils and stamps and whatever else, drawing, if you like to draw, doodle, any way you would like to decorate yours. And I've got a few of my favorite stamps out. I've got a couple of flowers. I've got a couple of hand-carved. I think we're doing that next week, aren't we? Oops. Just some little ones. So I'm going to get busy with stamping. I'm just using black ink, but obviously there are so many colors out there. You just choose what you want to use. Just make sure it gets all over your stamp and There you go. When I carve stamps, I like to do some long ones to sort of use for borders. They come out well. And then I have this cool, another one you can repeat. Let's put it on this page. We're not doing stamps next week, are we, Beth? We're doing yours, yeah? I can't remember. Anyway, I'll figure it out.
I just realized I responded to you and I was muted, but I was saying that if you want to change the order, that's fine with me.
No, you're going next week, right?
Well, yeah, according to the schedule, yes. Yes.
No, thank you, because I haven't even sent out my materials yet. So that's great.
I do have a couple of other little things that I forgot to add, of course, to the supply list.
Okay, well,
I'll send that to you.
Put it either that or just copy and paste it into the chat.
Will do.
I put my paint away, but I need them for the stencils. All righty. So when I do stenciling, I like to use this kind of almost like a makeup brush. It's very soft and it gets right down, and then you know, you can really get a good design out of it. So I'm going to try that. And something to put the paint on. Here. I'm going to use my golden fluid acrylic turquoise, which is what I used here. And I love the combination of the turquoise and the sort of orangey yellow. Okay, so that is what I'll use for this stenciling. Just pour some out. There's so many to choose from. You can see the ones I've already used because they have a little paint Yeah, that's a nice one. You just have to make sure that it's all the way down. You know, you run the risk of it bleeding underneath itself if it isn't all the way down. So I'm going to put it right here. That. And then I dab this little brush and then I dab it away so I can make sure I don't have too much. And then just hold that down.
I think I have a brush like that. That's a makeup brush. Is that what that is?
That is, yes.
That's cool. I've never used
it. I think Mary Beth Shaw taught me about that. And there you have it. Now, the thing with these stencils is you do have to clean them off, because if a little bit got underneath like there, the next time you use it, it will make a mess. So let me get a baby wipe. Clean this off. It doesn't have to be perfectly clean. It just needs to not be on the other side. Okay, and then find another one we like.
Pat, I'm gonna have to go.
Okay, Paloma, so good to see you again.
So good to see you. And you will send us the recording because I wanna see the end.
Yes, I will send the recording, definitely.
Thank you. It's lovely. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, now see, that made a big mess. And rather than wait for that to dry, I'm just gonna wipe it away and add that to the color and try again when that dries. That's the beauty of using these kind of paints. You never have to waste any of it. But that got underneath a little bit.
Looks nice with that color added to it.
Doesn't it? I mean, honestly, this turquoise looks so good with pretty much anything. Not so much on my fingers, though.
I seem to be way behind. Have you glued your envelopes together yet, or?
So here I'm using a different stencil and just some plain acrylic paint, not the golden fluid. You just see how that works. Put little bits of stencil here and there.
Kat, why do you choose to use a sponge in one way and a makeup brush in another?
I would use the makeup brush if it wasn't in the water.
Oh, gotcha.
And actually, with this paint, I think the sponges work just as well, if not better.
Okay. So,
yeah.
Also, Beth, I put a question in your comment, in the comments to you about, you mentioned having a pencil with an eraser, and I'm wondering, can they be separate entities, or do you need the kind of pencil that has...
No, they can be separate entities. Okay. I just want you to have a pencil and an eraser, that's all.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the sponge is actually working better on these stencils than with this paint.
Kat, I have to go in a few minutes to pick up my car from the dealer.
Oh, okay. Well, here, let's pause the recording. Tricked it.
Oh, very nice.
Right? Yeah, because I thought this was the back cover, but it's the front.
Oh.
So, didn't really want to. That's cool. Love the way this came out, that light blue paint on that greeny background.
Hmm.
Thank you. So I'm going to show you my finished one. Well, it's not totally finished yet. And then we can see yours.
Nice.
Still have a ways to go, but isn't this fun to just make a little something you can send off to a friend or make it into a little book? I hope you've enjoyed that.